Hello my dear friends, welcome back to the channel and this is your friend Dr. Suresh Hindle. Thank you so much for liking my earlier video on how to reduce the stress during exams. And today I am here with another video, that is how to excel in your post-graduation. All this information which I am sharing today in this video is based on my personal experience and I hope that those who watch this video find it really helpful. Coming to the first point, the first point is regarding the standard textbooks. I have seen that students are more into the information which is provided online rather than referring the standard textbooks. Most of the examiners would definitely ask you from which textbook you are giving the answer. Also, completing a post-graduation without reading standard textbooks is really not worth, because the information what is provided online may not be always evidence-based. And when you read the textbooks, you really find good amount of information which is printed after going through so many articles. I know it is difficult because you have the basic subject exam in the first year, and then when you come to the third year, you will end up having the thesis submission and the theory exams difficult to write if you read the standard textbooks. But trust me, you will be in a better position in future if you read the standard textbook, because one day you may be a teacher and that time you cannot tell a student that you have to find the answer from the Google. And I would like to share my own experience here. When I was in second year, I had read one or two textbooks of endodontics completely. And by that time, I had got an opportunity to edit the Dentist by Gauri Shankar book. And since I already had marked few important things from the endo textbook, it became really easy to find the references for various MCQ, and that opportunity really helped me to improve my career. So I hope that as a postgraduate student, you will really give importance to reading standard textbook for your field of post-graduation. Point number two, if you ask any postgraduate student who has worked hard and got a postgraduate seat, most of the time they will tell you that they are doing post-graduation because they want to learn or develop more amount of skill in dentistry. And that skill will only develop if you do more number of patients. If because of any reason you are wasting a lot of time in your post-graduation, you will lose so much amount of precious time which could have helped you to gain a lot of experience. And trust me, 3 years are not sufficient for any branch in post-graduation if you want to learn everything in that specialty. Even today, after 7 to 8 years of post-graduation, there are cases which are really challenging even in endodontics, and there are techniques which are always changing. So please give a lot of importance for your clinical work in your post-graduation, so that you really excel in your field. The third point is, how important is thesis? If you ask any student, we always run behind the thesis because it is a mandatory requirement for getting a postgraduate degree. Thesis is not a task. This skill is very important in future if you are going into the research field. And this skill will not develop very easily. So rather than struggling and thinking too much about the thesis submission, please concentrate on learning about the research, which will really help you in a long term. And no matter which college, which department you are, ultimately every student will submit the thesis at the end of third year. Coming to the fourth point, most of the time we stop learning about new materials because there are cases where the department may not be able to provide all the materials. But that should not stop you from learning the newer materials which are coming into the market. For that, of course, everybody argues that when you have paid so much of fees, why should I buy extra materials and learn those things? But there are situations where newer materials should be learned in your post-graduation, so that when you come out of the post-graduation, you already have experience in it. For example, when you were a post-graduate student, we used to buy a set of files, but it was expensive. So what we used to do is that if we have new file set and the files are 6 in number, we used to share the amount and everybody used to get newer material. So by this, we used to reduce the expenses and also gain the experience in the new material. So by doing this, you can always learn new things. So don't try out only those materials which are given by the department. If situation is feasible, try to buy new materials and learn about them. The next point is that at the end of post-graduation, you really want to feel confident so that you can decide a treatment plan for your patient, at least for the treatment which belongs to your field. I have seen many times the students, when they find difficult case and they are scared, they will ask their colleagues, their seniors to do the case. You will never develop skills to do the challenging cases. If you do the challenging cases over and over again, it is then the cases would become simple for you. The next point is, how are you managing your relation with your seniors, your colleagues and your juniors? Trust me, at the end of post-graduation, it was not about how many cases I had done, how much marks we had scored. Ultimately, we had a very nice culture where our juniors and seniors helped us a lot during the exam and toward the post-graduation. In undergraduation, you may have a lot of students, and if you are not good with some students, you still end up having a lot number of students with whom you can continue studying. But in post-graduation, the number is limited, and it is important that you maintain your relationship with everyone in a very good way. You will require the support of your senior, and your senior also will require your help during his exam. Similarly, you will require your junior's help during your examination. At the end of the post-graduation, you will make a lot of memories, and this relationship will survive throughout your life. And in future, after your post-graduation, your seniors, juniors will always there to help you whenever you need them. What about the articles? Articles, if you can publish them during post-graduation, then it is really good. But don't be disheartened if you have tried and you are not able to publish. Articles are important if you are applying for DDS or MS in foreign countries and in government jobs in India, because there are scores which are meant for articles, your work experience and so many other things. But if you plan to excel in your clinical practice, then maybe the articles may not have a lot of significance. But this should not stop you from working towards publishing good articles in your field during post-graduation, because you really don't know at what situation these articles can be helpful to you. The next point is, you should develop the public speaking skills. This is very important, because you never know, you may end up becoming a big speaker at various platforms. And that time, how you speak is more important than what you present. Also, in your clinical practice, it is mostly how you talk to your patient, how much trust the patient has on your words, that is going to decide your success. Of course, your clinical skill makes a lot of difference, but you really have to care for the patient, and sometimes it is only through the words. And this can be developed only if you do extempos during your post-graduation. You can't develop public speaking skills if you are reading the slides or just presenting the seminar or JCs without practicing it. The next important thing is, if some student from other college is asking for help, always try to help them, because by doing this, you are developing contacts at different places, and in future, these people will always remember that you had helped them during their post-graduation, and they would always try to help you in a similar way. For example, when I was in Davangere, we had a very good library and we had so many old journals, and many people used to call us or message us asking that they wanted the articles. And I always try to send them articles, and few of them do remember me even today because of that small help. The next point is about patient management. In 1 year, you will have 2-3 patients who will not be happy with the appointment schedule what you have provided to them, and they will always try to fight you so that they can finish the treatment earlier. And sometimes it is possible, sometimes it is not, and you are really helpless. But ultimately, the patient will go to the higher authority and the teacher will call you and ask you to do the treatment at the earliest. If ultimately, after all this argument, you still have to do that patient, then why not solve this issue at your level and be considerate for the request of the patient, if the request is very genuine. By doing this, you can always avoid a lot of stress. The next point is listen to your teachers. They have already made a lot of mistakes and they always wish good for you. For example, when I was doing post-graduation, my guide, Dr. Vasundhara Shivanna, always used to tell me that MDS is a degree and there is a lot to achieve in your life. And after struggling so much, getting good ranks in entrance, and when my teacher used to tell me that MDS is not sufficient, there is still a lot to excel, I really used to get sometimes worried. But when I came out of my post-graduation, I realized that whatever my teacher told me is to help me to prepare for my future. So do listen to them, because ultimately a good teacher always wishes well for their student. The last point is the marks may or may not matter in your post-graduation. There are situations where, in spite of putting a lot of effort, because of multiple factors, you may not end up getting a lot of marks. Don't be disappointed. Marks do matter if you are applying for foreign countries, but in foreign countries, apart from marks, they also see other aspects in your CV, like your work profile, your experience, and the articles and other presentations. If by any case you ended up getting less mark than what you deserve, then don't be disappointed. Your future is not decided by the marks of post-graduation. There is still a lot of work to do even after post-graduation. But that doesn't mean that you don't work hard in your post-graduation. Please remember, whatever happens, happens always for a reason. And the reason is always good. Thank you so much. I hope that these tips will be helpful to you. If you have any suggestions and requests, please write into the comment section. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Bye for now.